Over a dozen politicians addressed the crowd here tonight, but the man that people most wanted to hear from, Judge John Howard, was not here. He's a Baltimore City Circuit Court judge who is 4 years into his 15-year term, and he's taking a lot of criticism for allowing Stephen Pitcairn's alleged killer to stay out of jail for the past year despite repeated probation violations, and he has not responded to requests to explain his rulings. Dozens gathered on the spot where Stephen Pitcairn was stabbed to death Sunday night. Some came to mourn, all demanded action. Police Commissioner Fred Bielfeld kicked off the rally with an apology.
We're sorry we failed to protect Stephen Pitcairn.
But most of the people gathered here aren't pointing fingers at the police department. They're angry at Baltimore City Judge John Howard, who has a record of leniency towards John Wagner, one of Pitcairn's accused killers. Judge Howard repeatedly allowed Wagner to remain on the street, even after police captured this surveillance tape of Wagner in the red baseball cap allegedly robbing another man in April. Lawmakers expressed disgust and pledged to keep a closer watch on what goes on in Baltimore City courts.
Court watching to make sure that people who are arrested stay arrested.
To also demand that when our police do their job on the streets, that the rest of the system works and keeps perpetrators off our streets.
We're fed up and frustrated and angry that these things have to happen over and over and over again.
Six people have been killed in the Charles Village area this year. Some residents expressed frustration that it took Pitcairn's death to get lawmakers to address their concerns.
Shouldn't have come to this to make a difference. It's been like this for a long time.
This is not a safe neighborhood. There was a killing 100 feet away.
The crowd did come together on one point, gratitude for Reggie Higgins, the man who held Pitcairn as he died on the street. They also expressed a resolve to keep criminals from ruining Charles Village.
We've got to stand and fight. We've got to stand and clean our community up so these tragedies won't continue. If we keep running away, it's going to just move with us wherever we go.
Residents also wanted to hear from Baltimore City State's Attorney Patricia Jessamy this evening. She was here, but she declined to step up to the podium and take any questions. There is a meeting scheduled for people in this area to gather and come up with more ideas on how to fight crime. That's coming up on Saturday, August 7th. Reporting live in Charles Village, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.